going to talk about freshwater turtles. We've already talked about tortoises earlier. Freshwater turtles are divided into two parts. They can be hard-shell turtles and soft-shell turtles. This, just now we will look at a few soft-shell turtles. So this is a soft-shell turtle. It's called the Indian flap-shell turtle because of these very prominent flaps with which it can actually close these, see? It can take its legs inside and completely close it. So these are the flaps, which is from where it gets the name. So this is the Indian flap-shell turtle. It doesn't have a very hard carapace, and unfortunately this turtle has been quite extensively traded for various parts. They consider it to have medicinal value, but these are all old folks' tales. They don't have any truth in them. We're going to quickly do morphometry and identification for these three because they're Schedule 1 species. It's important for us to have data on these animals. So we're quickly going to do morphometry and marking on these animals, and then we will release them back into the enclosure. So like we did with the tortoises, I think it's important to keep data, morphometrics, weights, etc. for every species that we have. We have three soft-shell turtles with us now. So we will, because they don't have permanent ID yet, we will first do this. We will, they are distinctly different from each other, so we're going to be able to identify them individually. So right now we will name them as small, medium, large, and once we are going to move them into the pond, we will redo the morphometrics and give them a permanent identification at that time. But for us to start with the data work and getting the data together and starting the identification process, we're going to do this exercise. So we'd start with the smallest first. So let's start with the weight. Morphometrics, doing this as a team is always a good thing because more eyes are always better. So we will all look at this turtle, and it's also a time when we can do an estimation of health, do a quick visual checkup, and then, you know, sort of plan a procedure if we have to, in addition to what we're doing with the morphometric. So we'll first take the weight. And can you read the weight there, please, Dr. Pushatam? 600 grams. Now, I want you to please hold this. So the flaps are also used to always hold it upright. Never turn it on the back and keep the flaps steady so that we know what we're doing. We're going to take the carapace length first. No turtle wants to bite you, but when we do these things, we put them in a very vulnerable position. So they're always going to try and escape. So one of the things to do is to do this quickly. 16 centimeters carapace length. Centimeters carapace width. So carapace width is again done at the widest point of the flare. And plastron length, 16.5 centimeters. So it's a difficult thing to do with these animals when you're trying to look at whether it's a male or a female, because they have this flap and they take their tail inside. But the rule of the thumb may not necessarily work every time. So you're able to do identification based on sizes to say male and female, stuff like that, when they're mainly adult animals. So they're reaching a sexual maturity age. But with very small animals, it's very difficult to do. And sometimes, like in this animal, the tail is broken, so we won't be able to tell. So we're just going to have to estimate this, and I think this is a male, depending on where the location of the vent is. So the vent is outside this, if you pull. So the vent is outside, so it's a male. So we're going to call this as, you will record this as small male, and you've got the data together as well. So this is the largest animal that we have, and the third in the lot. So we'll finish this quickly so that we can go ahead. And the weight, please.
1.5 kg.
Now we'll do the carapace length. So take it right at the center from the top here to the top edge here. There we go. 24 and a half. Plastron length.
It's
23. Yeah. Right? Okay. For the last of the Chelonian sessions, we're going to look at this animal. This is a red-eared slider. It's called Trachymis crypta elegans. That's the scientific name for the species. This is not an Indian animal. This is a non-native species. It's unfortunately very widely traded in the market today, but we do find it in collections here, and also in the pet market. So anyway, we will look at why this is called a hard-shelled turtle and what is the difference between a turtle, hard-shelled turtle, and what everyone calls as a terrapin. Someone very wise told me once that working with reptiles teaches you humility and patience, and it's very true. So here you will see that they have very long nails or claws, and also between them there is some webbing in the feet. And with the soft-shell turtles that were there, the webbing in the feet was far more pronounced, and that's why this turtle is also capable of moving on land just as well as that it is swimming in water. So this is why this is a turtle. And a terrapin is a term used for species that are quite comfortable in brackish water. India actually has only one species of terrapin, and that is the northern river terrapin. It is found in the Sundarbans area in West Bengal, and it's the scientific name for that species is Patagur pasca. So that's the true terrapin, because it lives in fresh water but also in the brackish water of the Sundarbans. This species, where it is found, is also used to some amount of brackish water habitat, so it's okay to call this a terrapin. So all hard-shell turtles are not terrapins, but all terrapins are hard-shell turtles. So this is an interesting factoid that we have. So let's do the morphometrics and see how this goes. You're a big girl. Yeah, so this, she's big. She's almost 3 kilos, and it's easier, she's calmer on this, otherwise she's going to fight. So why don't we do the morphometrics when she's sitting happily right here? So we have carapace length, which is
29 centimeters.
The reason for doing this, you can take the carapace width. The reason for doing this carapace width, etc., also tells you how much egg bearing capacity is there in a female when she is matured, because the flare is at exactly where the pelvic girdle would be. So it gives you a lot of information, and it's important to collect this data accurately. You've got the... Okay, there we go. And we have plastron length. Right, and with that we finish with our Chelonians.